On July 1st, 2021, the first eruption at the Taal Volcano in 18 months began. Over the span of 5 minutes at 3:16 p.m. local time, a volcanic explosion occurred which ejected bombs of lava and particles of ash. As you can see in this video, the explosion generated a series of pyroclastic flows which traveled about a kilometer within the main crater lake of this volcano. However, given recent long-term seismic activity and unusually high emissions of sulfur dioxide from this volcano, a larger eruption is almost certain. As a result, tens of thousands of people have been ordered to evacuate. Although a large evacuation radius has not yet been ordered, residents up to 16 kilometers away need to be prepared to evacuate. The graphics being shown on screen display the areas at risk for volcanic bombs, volcanic tsunamis, and pyroclastic flows from this highly dangerous volcano. Before I state what I expect to occur in the next few weeks, let me summarize what has happened so far since its last eruption in January of 2020. The Taal Volcano can be found on the island of Luzon in the central western Philippines. Specifically, it is 66 kilometers south of Manila. At first glance, it may appear as though the Taal Volcano is just the island in the middle of the large lake. However, looks can be deceiving. The volcano actually encompasses the entire lake, as the lake is the result of several supermassive eruptions. Four ancient caldera collapses created the lake, each of which was several times larger than the 1991 eruption of Mount Pinatubo. The last of these large eruptions occurred in 3580 BC. Thus, the lake represents the volcanic equivalent of a sinkhole. Since eruptions from this volcano began to be recorded in 1572, 36 different eruptions have occurred. All of these eruptions have originated from the island in the center of the crater lake, although at varying vents on the island. If you look closely, you can see ring-shaped features called tuff rings, which are the result of highly explosive eruptions. As an example, the site of the 2020 eruption and the eruption earlier today was the main crater lake. This eruption was preceded by a strong swarm of earthquakes which had been ongoing for many months. These earthquakes were caused by the movement of magma beneath the volcano. Due to the unusually high amount of earthquakes which occurred, I fully expect an eruption from Taal to be larger than its 2020 eruption. Another warning sign was only a few days ago, as the volcano emitted absurdly high levels of sulfur dioxide gas. There are many actively erupting volcanoes on the planet that weren't even emitting levels a fraction of that size. Sulfur dioxide is one of many gases emitted by magma, so its presence indicates that lava is either erupting or close to the surface. Although eruptions are difficult to predict, this is what I expect to occur in the next several weeks. More explosions will occur within the crater lake on the Taal Island. These explosions will vary in size, as they are caused by the interaction of magma with water, which causes the water to flash to steam and explode. Before each of these explosions, the crater lake will slightly drop in height. Eventually, enough explosions will have occurred that the crater lake will have been completely vaporized. Then, I fully expect to see a large eruption of magma onto the island, which could occur at more than one vent simultaneously. During this phase of the eruption, Taal would be the most dangerous, as it could potentially generate long-distance pyroclastic flows. These pyroclastic flows could easily travel across the entire lake and travel uphill on land up to 16 kilometers away. Although I do not expect pyroclastic flows even a fraction of this maximum size to occur, the potential definitely exists. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, if you wish to support this channel, consider becoming a patron on Patreon.